Hello everyone, myself Srishti Tiwari from 11th Commerce. Today we are going to discuss the topic which is nature and significance of business and how we can apply skill in business. So our first topic is activities. Activities are classified into two main parts, economic activities and non-economic activities. Economic activities, those activities which are performed by us so that we can earn our livelihood are called as economic activities. For example, employment, business, profession. In other words, all the work that we are doing for earning profit or for money are called as economic activities. Next, non-economic activities. Those activities which are performed out of love, sympathy, sentiments, etc. are called as non-economic activities. For example, the love of our mother, father, parents, grandparents are considered as economic activities. Now next is types of economic activities. Economic activities are classified into three main parts, profession, employment and business. Profession. It includes those activities which requires special knowledge and skills to be applied by the individuals in their occupation. For example, teachers, poets, artists are considered as professionals. Why? Because they have their own knowledge and skill. Employment. Employment refers to the occupation in which people work for others and get remuneration in return. For example, workers that doing work in the factories are called as employers because they are doing employment. It refers to those activities which are connected with the product or purchase and sale of goods or services with the main objective to earn profit. In other words, business refers to an occupation in which pupils are performing economic activities regularly with the main motive of earning profit. Next, features of business. It is considered as an economic activities. Business is considered as an economic activities. Next, product or procurement of goods and services. Before goods are offered to people for consumption, it may be either procured or produced by business enterprises. Sale or exchange goods and services for the satisfaction of human needs. Business involves transfer or exchange of goods and services. If goods are produced not for sale, it cannot be considered as business activity. Fifth, dealings in goods and services on a regular basis. Business involves dealing in goods and services on regular basis. One single transaction of sale or purchase cannot be considered as business activity. Next, profit earning. Profit earning is the main objective of business activity. No business can survive for a long time without earning profit. Element of risk. Risk is also an essential feature of business. It is caused by unfavorable or undesirable events, for example, earthquake, floods, dishonesty of workers, etc. Next, uncertainty of returns. The money that we have invested in our business, there is no certainty of its return. Let's move towards next topic, which is classification of business activity. Business are classified into two main parts, industry and commerce. Industry, it refers to an economic activity which are connected with conversion of resources into useful goods. It means industries are converting raw materials into finished goods. Next, activities which are necessary for facilitating exchange of goods and services are termed as commerce. Commerce is boon for business in modern era because commerce facilitating us so many facilities for improving our business. Now next topic is classification of industry. Industries are classified into three main parts, primary, secondary and tertiary. Primary industries. The industries which are concerned with the production of natural resources are called as primary industries. फॉर एग्जाम्पल एग्रीकल्चरल फिशेज एक्सेट्रा. सेकेंडरी इंडस्ट्रीज. दीज इंडस्ट्रीज आर कंसर्न विद द यूज ऑफ दोज मटीरियल्स विच हैज़ बीन ऑलरेडी एक्सट्रैक्टेड एट प्राइमरी स्टेजेस. फॉर एग्जाम्पल स्टील प्रोडक्शन, ऑटोमोबाइल मैन्युफैक्चरिंग, सुगर प्रोडक्शन एक्सेट्रा. टर्शियरी इंडस्ट्रीज. दीज इंडस्ट्रीज provides support to the primary and secondary industries for their development. For example, through banking, insurance, etc. Now next is classification of primary industries. Primary industries are classified into two main parts, extractive industry and genetic industry. Extractive industries. These industries extract or draw out products from natural resources. It means extractive industries utilize their products from natural resources. For example, mining, etc. Now next, genetic industries. These industries remain engaged in breeding plants and animals for their use in further reproduction. Genetic industries mainly involve in breeding of animals and plants. Let's move towards our next topic, which is classification of secondary industry. Secondary industries are classified into two main parts, manufacturing and construction. These industries are engaged in producing goods through processing of raw materials and thus creating farm utilities. Manufacturing industries involves many processes for utilizing raw materials. Construction. These industries are involved in the construction of buildings, dams, bridges, roads, as well as tunnels and canals. Constructive industries mainly involves architect and engineering. Now next is classification of manufacturing. Manufacturing are classified into four main parts: analytical, synthetical, processing and assembling. Analytical. These industries analyzes and separates different elements from same materials, as in the case of oil refineries, oil, petroleum, etc. Next, synthetical. These industries combines various ingredients to make a new product. For example, cement. Next, processing. These industries involves successive stages for manufacturing finished products, for example, sugar and paper. Now next is assembling. These industries assembles different component parts to make a new product. For example, this mobile phone, television, cars, etc. Thank you so much.
Attaining knowledge, accomplishing goals, achieving success.